this recording
is Sardar Patel University. Presently, he serves as the director of Custom Healthcare Private Limited since June 2012. The firm was established with the sole intention of serving people with the best and latest advancements in homeopathic medicine. Sir is the pioneer in the new era of tech-based online homeopathy consultation. His pioneering work in conducting online homeopathy consultation with various options which are available with only some homeopaths in India has sparked innovation and change. Sir Jignesh possesses more than 20 years of expertise in homeopathic medicine. I would like to take a moment to acknowledge the significance of their presence here today. Their dedication to the pursuit of knowledge and their willingness to impart their wisdom is commendable. I extend a heartfelt invitation to our guest speaker, Sir Jignesh, to grace the stage. Please, sir.
Thank you very much. First of all, I am thankful to St. Xavier's College and ma'am, and as per my special thanks to Mr. Maulik Dilani, by whom I am here. And now we shall start quickly. So this is the first slide. Welcome to the world of holistic healing, homeopathy, the world's best painless healing drug. The sun method is a small part of it. The introduction has already been there. Then also this is the brief introduction. Graduate of BHMS and graduation from Anand Homeopathic Medical College. Service to IATS of Rajasthan Hospital and BSS is an NGO international level. It has branches something all over the world, at least 50 to 60 countries. So this is our motto. We want to reach home by homeopathy at each and every year. This is the target by 2030. And this is our slogan, heal well, heal fast. So most of the persons have the tendency that homeopathy doesn't heal fast. How many of you think like that? If at all you are in doubt, then you can just raise your fingers. How many of you have such a query that homeopathy doesn't heal fast? You don't have. Anybody has used homeopathic medicine ever in their life? Okay, fine. So what was the approach? Did it get the result fast or it was taking time?
Taking time.
Okay, so that is another we shall discuss afterwards. But your concept, heal well, heal fast, means we are healing faster also. There are some concepts. So now we shall start off. What is homeopathy? Homeopathy is a healing art which was propounded by an allopath and flourished all over the world due to its most harmless property. Homeopathy means home is similar and pathy means therapy. So it is based on the system that similar curanda that will come afterwards. But the like cures like is the principle. A person named Samuel Hahnemann, who was the founder of homeopathy, was born on 10th April 1755 in Meissen, Saxony. Now it is in Germany. He studied and completed his MD medicine from Erlangen in 1779 and started practicing allopathy and became a renowned allopath. He was a very well-known allopath. He had started his practice as an allopath. But soon after his earlier phase of practice, he came to know about the side effects of allopathy, and he got so frustrated with it that he left the practice of allopathy, and he was very kind to person, so he could not tolerate any harm to anybody due to the medicine. Then he started a job as a translator. And during the translation, one Kulins Mathematica was there. So he was trying the translation, and he got a verse that the Simpona bark has a tendency to cure or treat the malaria because of its bitterness and some positive effects on stomach. But he could not believe that. So what he did, he just started his experiments on his own. He took 4 drams of Simpona bark liquid for approximately 2 days, 2 times, And what happened? After 2 days, he got all the symptoms of malaria. So this was the initiation of homeopathy. Then the symptoms of malaria was developed. So he thought that if the drug has tendency to produce the disease, it can also cure it. On that basis, he just started experimenting on so many other drugs also, other medicines also. And this process continued for something 6 years. So from 1790 to 1796. And in 1796, he came to the conclusion that if medicine has the tendency to produce the disease in a healthy human being, see, this is the main and most important part of homeopathy. If at all you are knowing about the drug proving, anybody knows about drug proving, how it has been proved? At least little bit knowledge regarding drug proving. But you might not be aware, but all the drugs are being proved either on mice, rats, any sort of organism, frogs and any, or lastly on some diseased person, any drug whatsoever. But what in homeopathy we do, we prove all our medicines on healthy human beings. On healthy human beings. That is a very particular thing. That we give or dispense medicine to healthy human beings. We just give them medicine and tell them, give them a diary, tell them to note down all the symptoms, whatsoever they suffer from. And that is called materia medica, the compilation of all those symptoms from all those patients, we don't say patients, all those human beings, that is a compilation. So that is called materia medica. Means a single drug is being proved on several of the healthy human beings. And that compilation makes a materia medica. So drug has each and every symptom. And this is the sole thing which has medicine for each and everything. Each and everything means each and everything. If your right eye is blinking, then that is another medicine. If your left one is there, it is another medicine. If there is itching in right eye, then another medicine. So there is so much difference. If you have headache, then there are thousands of medicine. So we may go forward. History of homeopathy. Cure takes place with disappearance of symptoms. This is the Herring's law of cure. Actually, we missed something. So this is the Herring's law of cure. Homeopathy just goes on the basis of Herring's law of nature's law of cure. What does the nature's law of cure say? The cure should take place in such a manner that cure takes place with disappearance of the symptoms from above downwards. Means from head to foot. Head is very important part of your body. So it should go from head to foot. Then above downwards, the similar thing. Inside outwards, means from in the inside of your body there are vital organs which are very important ones. So from inside outwards. And the similar one, that more important organs to lesser important organs. Disappearance should be in the manner that from this first appeared symptom should go last and last one should go first. So this is the main Herring's law of cure. And if at all a cure occurs in such a manner, then only it will be a permanent cure. Otherwise the cure cannot be permanent. It would be either palliation or suppression. That's what which occurs in allopathy. We would lastly give one example that how allopathy and homeopathy is being differentiated and what is the basic difference in very simple manner. But just first of all go through this thing. So principles of homeopathy. As mentioned in previous slides, anyone propounded homeopathy by virtue of law of similars, like cures like or similar similars, curanda. Briefly we can say that a substance which has tendency to cause certain disease in a healthy individual can itself cause the same disease in a diseased person if given homeopathically in a diluted form without any sort of side effects. This thing is known as potentization. We will discuss it further. Homeopathy does not consider a disease, it considers a person as a whole. This is the main thing, that we do not consider disease. We don't believe in any sort of diseases. There is nothing like disease. Homeopath, the Hahnemann, he said that you should not run after searching out for the disease. That is just a waste of time. He used to say that speculative investigations means blood reports, sonography and all those stuff. If at all you have a single symptom and if you give a medicine on that basis, then what will happen? If the symptom is removed, then the disease will be removed by itself. This is the main concept of homeopathy. So we need not go into the deep by these sort of investigations. Homeopathy does not consider disease, homeopathy cures the disease by activating the vital force. So this is the main concept of homeopathy. Vital force is a very vast subject. We cannot describe in such a limited time. But I would like to say that it is the thing which controls your body. Each and every part of your body is being controlled by vital force. If your vital force is normal, then only you can walk or you can do a single sort of walk. If vital force is not normal, then it will cause damage to any sort of the organ. Either it could be finger, it could be head. So any level it can damage. And if at all it is in sound condition, then you will be okay. So what you need to do, you need to just activate the vital force. And if vital force is activated, it will stimulate the body and body will walk out and body will remove the disease. So this is the difference. In allopathy, the drug removes the disease, but body is just sitting up. It doesn't walk out. So this is the vast difference, and due to this only cure is possible. That body itself removes the disease. So it does it in such a manner that nothing remains. But drug has limitations. It can just suppress and afterwards it can recover. So as I told you that it is completely removed from the body. Principles of homeopathy. Hahnemann called homeopathy as an art of healing. This word is very important, your art. We don't say it is an apathy or anything else, it is an art only. Your this word, art. Okay, so art is very important. What do you mean by art? It is not a mechanical process, what I mean to say. It is not a mechanical process. It is just cultivated, it is just inside the mind. Means if at all you are being told to design something, so that is an art. You know, that is an art. It comes from within. So this is the thing. Means healing art. You have to study the patient in such a manner that nothing remains. Each and every symptom you have to study very deeply. You have to study from head to foot, from eyes to toes. Each and every symptom, the color of nails, color of eyes, whether he or she is wearing spectacles, what is the kind of ears, either your lobe is being touched. So everything you have to study. On that basis, you just have a collection of the symptoms. You study the symptom and after that you have to recognize them. And you get a single medicine which will be working and which will give results. So homeopathy is the only path in the universe which considers diseased person as well, not to be the cure. Disease is not to be cured over here. You have you seen any therapy which has a medicine to treat dreams? Have you? No. Okay. Which medicine besides homeopathy can treat the dreams of thieves? Is there any pathy in the world? Have you seen? No, nowhere. This is the only pathy which can even treat a specific dream. This is the peculiarity of homeopathy. Nowhere else such a thing is there. And modalities and all the stuff, that if a person is becoming sick, then there would be a specific time that between 10 to 2 p.m. only that person would be sick. Otherwise he would be absolutely fine. So this is the peculiarity of homeopathy. This is the charm that it has medicine. Each and everything under this universe, even for expression, even for sensation, and even for phobias. Phobias like fear of dog, fear of fire, and fear of death, prediction of death. Yeah, this is the main thing. There are certain persons who can predict the exact time of their death. He would say, when that person is ill, he would say, I will be dying at this time. This is the thing that person would say. So if you give a specific medicine, I will also name that medicine. The name of the medicine is Absinthe. It is a very funny and very interesting medicine. It is known as Polycrest medicine. It covers most of the symptoms of the person. But this medicine has a peculiarity. If a person is having fear of death and he predicts the exact time of death, then you give a single dose of arsenic, one and to that particular person, that fear of death will be gone. And you will be happy person. There are hundreds of medicines in homeopathy, as I mentioned earlier, considered as a whole, that is also considered. And it removes the medicine from the disease from the roots. This is the main thing, that it removes the disease from the roots. Homeopathy removes the disease from the roots. It neither suppresses the disease nor palliates the disease. Do you understand the difference between palliation, suppression and cure? Do you have any sort of knowledge regarding these three terms? Okay, what is palliation? This is simple English word. I think you might be knowing. What is palliation? What is palliation? Anybody? If anybody knows, please raise your finger. Question would be afterwards, but just a simple single word. Nobody? Okay, fine. So, mode of action of homeopathy. Here also we are not using the word drug. Mode of action of medicine. Okay, we don't use drug. Why we don't use the word drug, we will explain afterwards. Homeopathy cures the disease. It neither palliates nor suppresses. And meaning means completely removed from the body. Medicine is potentized form. This is which we told you earlier, that potentized form, we use it in potentized form. Potentization is the process of dilution. We dilute the medicines at a such a level that no crude substance is present. You might be knowing regarding the Avogadro's number. Anybody? Okay. So it is 6.02 × 10⁻³. So after that level, the existence of mass is not there. Means you cannot have a single sort of molecule if you cross this level. So we dilute our medicines at the level of 10⁻³. It is far beyond 10⁻²³. Means more 7 times. So this is the main reason why homeopathy doesn't have any sort of side effects. This process is either known as potentization, or we can also say dynamization. Means only dynamic power of that particular medicine remains, and all the crude substance whatsoever was present in that medicine is zero at this level, 10⁻³. Okay, so nothing remains. Means if no crude substance is there, there are no chances of any sort of side effects. So we have explained this. Did you get it? Why homeopathy doesn't have side effect? Yeah. Clear? No? Fine. So brief one, as I mentioned earlier, that complete case taking is bunk done, and after that similar medicine is being selected and it works out and cures the disease. Why homeopathy? Isn't it? This is very important question. Why homeopathy? Why you should take homeopathy medicines? Okay, question will be afterwards, but just brief in one or two, not sentence, but what anybody would like to say, why homeopathy? Whosoever has taken, not who has taken, but whosoever has taken homeopathy.
No side effect.
Fine. Anything else? Yes, you are very careful.
Homeopathy does not have the problem of the bacteria building resistance to the particular drug. Like in allopathy, generally the bacteria develop resistance against a particular antibiotic over a period of years.
Such resistance is not there. Fine. Very nice. But actually we don't have such a concept. That's a totally different thing. But we have addressed it very nicely. So this was the thing. Homeopathy cures the disease, no side effects, and safe for children and lactating women. Everybody is safe. It is also affordable compared to other pathies, and as it doesn't require any sort of investigation, in another way it is more affordable. Easily palatable also. Sweet pills cures. So that is the main thing. Why should you take some bitter thing when you are getting sweet pills and you are being cured? So that is the main thing. And it is most favorite thing of children. This is the only clinic in the world where children enter happily and exit happily. We see that. Why? Because sweet pills are there. And they want to visit this place again and again. Doctor ke paas jata hai mujhe. Doctor meethi goli denge mujhe. दूसरे डॉक्टर तो कड़वी दवाई देते हैं, मुझे वो पसंद नहीं है, मैं वहां नहीं जाऊंगा, या अगर सही डॉक्टर के पास जाना है. सो वी आर देयर हैप्पी. सो वी लाइक दैट एंड वी आर मोर हैप्पियर देन देम. द दिस इज द टेस्टिमोनियल. डू यू फॉलो गुजराती? दिस टेस्टिमोनियल इज इन गुजराती. लेट्स सी.
Speak
sound will be proper. Shows 100% that the
એના કરતા અમે બેસ્ટ છે. Bijou Kriyanayishe, first all the best. Thank you.
Actually, this patient was suffering from bronchiectasis. It is a very severe grade of lung disease in which the alveoli, do you know the anatomy of lungs? Alveoli are there. They are sort of balloon-like structure in the lung. So what happens in bronchiectasis? These balloons does not constrict. They just remain open. So due to which what happens? Whensoever you get infection like common cold, this infection is being penetrated into this alveoli, and due to that this person suffers from such a level of breathlessness that he is not able to do his routine activities also. You have seen that person, he was sitting calmly in front of me, but only a stage when he appeared to me at first time, he had to sit for 5 minutes and then he was able to speak, but afterwards now he is absolutely fine. So this is the charm of homeopathy. So now we shall proceed further. This is our contact, and this will be the question and answer section. And thanks a lot for hearing me calmly. So now we shall start question and answer section. So anybody who would like to ask anything? Regarding homeopathy, let me now say the basic difference between allopathy and homeopathy. Firstly, for females, and this will be in Hindi. आप लोग क्या घर में सफाई करते हो? Gents generally नहीं करते, इसलिए मैं female को बोला है कि अभी तो ऐसे सब करने लगे हैं, तो आप भी मामला बदल चुका है. पर फिर भी फीमेल के लिए ज्यादा एक वर्क कहा जाता है एज अ सॉर्ट ऑफ थिंग. तो जैसे आप सफाई करते हैं तो झाड़ू लगाते हैं, झाड़ू लगाने के बाद आप क्या करते हैं? जो कचरा होता है उसका क्या करते हैं आप? कचरा डस्टबिन में डालते हैं. ठीक है, डस्टबिन में डाला, उस कचरे का क्या करते हैं? वो जाता है सीधा गाड़ी जो आती है उसके अंदर चले जाता है. ठीक है, अब वो कचरा क्या आपके घर में वापस कभी आएगा? पॉसिबल है? वो वही कचरा जो आपने गाड़ी में डाल दिया था वो क्या आपके घर में कभी आ सकता है वापस? इज इट पॉसिबल? किसी को डाउट हो तो आज ऊपर कर भी वापस आएगा मेरे घर में, ऐसा हो सकता है क्या? नहीं ना. फाइन, अब दूसरा सिनेरियो देखते हैं कि जैसे आपने सफाई कर ली है, ठीक है, आपको थोड़ी जल्दी है कि नहीं मुझे फटाफट काम करना है, टाइम बिल्कुल नहीं है. तो आपने सफाई करके आपने जो भी कचरा था इकट्ठा हुआ है उसको एक कोने में इकट्ठा करके रख दिया. अब उसका क्या होगा? क्या होगा उसका? सपोज आपको गर्मी लग रही है, पंखा वंखा भी चालू कर सकते हैं ना, तो पंखा चालू किया, फिर क्या होगा? वो कचरा क्या पूरे रूम में फैल जाएगा ना. तो आपने जो मेहनत की थी उसका क्या हुआ? ऑल वॉज इन वेस्ट. नो, बेकार गया ना, सब मेहनत की हो बेकार गई ना. समझे? सो सेकंड एग्जांपल वाज ऑफ एलोपैथी एंड फर्स्ट एग्जांपल वाज ऑफ होम्योपैथी. दिस इज एज सिंपल एज दैट. गॉट इट? आप घर बार में फटाफट करना चाहते हैं, चलो मुझे यार सर्दी और नाक फटाफट इतनी ज्यादा बह रही है, बहुत परेशानी है, व्हाट शुड आई डू नाउ? ले लेते हैं एक क्या नाम भी याद, क्या नाम है, क्या जस्ट सर
लिवोसिट्रोसिन.
क्या? गॉट इट. लिवोसिट्रोसिन. सी इन दिस मैनर whenever you will be able to remember the name of homeopathic drug or medicine, what you say, if you will be able to remember the name of medicine in such a manner, then the day will come when everybody would be healthy. And I would like to say one thing at this urge, that if you start with the childhood, when a kid is there, maybe since birth, if at all he or she is suffering from any sort of disease, and if you give him or her homeopathic medicine since inception, if that child, particular child, reaches at the age of 70 years, then what will happen? This person, you told them that most of the drugs become resistant. What is that? Resistance means? Means the level of drug, the action or the power of drug against the body decreases. It doesn't happen with everybody. This drug resistance is different for different persons. Okay? So, with homeopathy, what
what will happen at the level of 70 years also, you will be able to give a simple drug like azithromycin, which works on 3 months of kids also and 5 months of kids also, and very, very effectively that.